would like to welcome you to St. Matthew's Lutheran Church. We have represented here three of our college choirs. The choir that is filing back right now is our day choir called the College Choir. The choir in front of you now is our concert singers. And also in this program, included in these two groups, is our vocal ensemble. We would like now to feature the groups in an antiphonal setting, and we are very happy to be able to use this facility because the organ is set up antiphonally as well, of an old Renaissance number, which we are doing in English, called Come, Let Us Sing.
Come, let us sing. satchels of money, the dream machine jiggles and steams, stoked by the man under the bed. The emperor of emptiness, of galaxies of dust, and his hairy shadow who feeds on children's feet. I hear him sometimes, hooting up out of boredom, from the death side of the pillow, tired of crumbs. Oh, tired of crumbs and his restive menagerie. I hear him sometimes, and go dreaming my way to him, among the animals, the loot, the antique swords, the rubies, and the damp wings of Kleenex. He has all your faces, love, a quick change artist, of the silly and beautiful, one hand on the tiller of that fabulous machine that whistles and boils, turns over the waves to the endless kingdom of treasure and junk, all night tangled as firmly as past and future in each other's arms. The dream machine jiggles and steams, stoked by the man under the bed.
Oh, Thank you. his whitewashed brush. "Bother and blow," said Mole, and he bolted out of the house without even waiting to put on his coat. Something up above was calling him into the sunlight and away, across the meadows and alongside the copses, trotting along the riverbank, where all of a sudden he sat down, entranced and bewitched. As he sat on the grass and looked across the river, he became aware of a bright little star winking at him from the opposite bank. The star became an eye, and then there was another eye, then a small brown face with whiskers.
"Hello, Mole."
"Hello, Rat."
"I was just going off for a trip down the river. Would you like to come?"
"Well, I'm not sure."
"He wouldn't come," said Rat. "Simply hates society." "Well then, why don't we go and call on him?" suggested Mole. "It's a long journey," replied Rat, "but perhaps we should pay him a visit, especially as Christmas is coming on." So one cold December day, they set off together through the wild wood till they reached Badger's house.
Oh,
confound you, wretched field mice. I suppose you'd better come in.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Badger, sir, thank you.
You may later sing one verse of some brief soothing carol. For the moment, be silent while I talk with Mr. Rat and Mr.
sternly, Toad, you unhappy creature. Me unhappy? Exclaimed Toad. What a lot of rot you do talk, Badger. Why, I'm the happiest creature alive. The open road, the smell of hot oil. If you chaps can't recognize the coming thing when you see it, then I'm afraid progress won't wait for you, and no more shall I. Must be off. See you up at my place sometime. And with that, Toad started up the car and drove off. But that wasn't the end of it, as I'm sure we'll see.
Silence! Silence in court!
Save the occasional spider, and no solace, save that provided by a tin mug of brackish water and the stale crusts thrown to him from time to time. And oh, I nearly forgot, the rather comely and kind-hearted daughter of one of the jailers. Let us eavesdrop as she attempts to rout the starving and disconsolate felon.
Let me tickle your fancy toes. Nice bowl of tripe. Can't you work up an appetite? How about liver and lights?
Well,
fish is good for the brain, they say. Like some bloaters and brine.
Some hot drink.
Don't you fancy things salty?
I do.
Care to try something new?
jailer's daughter had to offer seemed to rouse him. But like all great men of history, his single-mindedness saw him through. He escaped by exchanging clothes with a humble washerwoman. Let us join him as he makes his way back to Toad Hall, a sadder and wiser Toad. I'm not sure that's true, actually, but perhaps I'd better let you be the judge. Here he is.
I've got style, I've got chic, I've got charisma, I've got misty. All my friends tell me so, and after all, they ought to know. Such an air, debonair, such sophistication, some affair, so meet God's day, so will meet. The people come to cheer me when I walk down the street. I'm a toad, I'm the greatest. I get called by Scotland Yard. They have to bring me in when it gets too hot. Einstein, lessons from me. I showed him that MC square equals E.
Here we go.
Mozart and Schubert and Luke and Mary. Would have had a lot more hints and they could study with me. Michelangelo's drawings were absolutely appalling. If I had done the Sistine ceiling, you would find it more appealing.
And the ferrets and the smokes, brandishing our weapons and saying, ashes and blood burning August.
It was nearly midnight when Badger rose to his feet, rather unsteadily, and addressed the assembled company.